Welcome back. Researchers are looking into the risk factors for dementia, and one of the particular concerns is hearing loss.
Now, joining us this morning from Gundersen Health System is audiologist Dr. Justin Wilson. Dr. Wilson, thanks for being with us this morning.
Thank you for having me.
So we know the chances of hearing loss increase with age, but just how common is hearing loss itself?
Well, depending on the source you reference, between 35 and 48 million Americans have some degree of hearing loss, as much as 10 to 20% of the population. The incidence definitely increases as we age. Half of those age 75 and above, a third of those age 65 to 74, and even 15% of baby boomers have disabling hearing loss. It's the third most prevalent chronic health condition.
Wow.
And you know, what are some of the possible causes of the hearing loss and dementia relationship?
That's a good question, Lindsay. This is kind of a hot topic in the medical field. Hearing loss is an invisible handicap and so common, it's been long considered just a normal part of the aging process. Dr. Frank Lin at Johns Hopkins University found a link between hearing loss and dementia. This means the hearing loss is a greater health threat than commonly accepted and should no longer be just considered an inconsequential part of aging. The greater the hearing loss, the more the risk. Mild hearing loss represented twice the risk, moderate three times, and severe as much as five times the risk. Some of the possible relationships come down to three main components: social isolation, brain atrophy, and cognitive resource depletion. Cognitive resource depletion theory states that since so much brain power is dedicated to processing individual speech sounds and words, there's less mental power left over for higher level functions, such as remembering what was said and thinking as a whole. Imagine squinting at the chalkboard all day long trying to see. By the end of the day, you'd be exhausted or at least fatigued. It could be that years of this takes a toll on the hearing impaired cognitive process.
Oh, that's fascinating.
Atrophy.
Yeah, we are running out of time. I just want to get to this real quick. So looking at these connections, do we think that treating hearing loss can help reduce this risk?
That's the burning question. Definitive studies are in process, but preliminary results do suggest yes. Improving hearing with well-fit hearing aids does have cognitive benefits.
Okay, that's good to know. At least, you know, make sure to treat it if it's something that's creeping up on you. Dr. Wilson, we thank you for joining us this morning.
Thank you.
All right, coming up on 10 minutes before 7 o'clock, time now for your Morning Sparks, a new segment to help prompt little minds. And today's challenge, tell a story about your parents and a food they did or didn't like. What did you think of this food then, and what do you think of it now?
And it helps build brains by helping a child feel like they are part of an important group. Storytelling also builds confidence. We'll be right back with a check of your day planner outlook next.